Need a roof over your head? Only place in town.
I found your grandpa. Not much left except his hat.
Grandpa Savoldi. Damn. People on the hill don't think kindly about the Minutemen. Say they didn't help when we needed them. My grandpa was a hero. And I won't hear anything different.
Died fighting for the Commonwealth. He's a hero in anyone's book.
Wish more people looked at it that way. Here's the reward. You earned it.
If you're here about the missing caravan, the contract's already been picked up.
Bar's open. Just don't get so drunk you shoot up the place.
Hey. Come on.
Sure.
Hancock.
You look like you could use this.
Thoughts?
World's always gonna have tyrants, but if I get my way, there'll be a lot less.
That was all I had.
Gotcha.
Take a look at you. See where it hurts.
I need some supplies, Doctor.
All right. But go easy on the chems.
Not a lot of folks would travel with a ghoul. Even one with my kind of charisma.
I'm just here between jobs.
Hey again. Step right up. Little bit of everything
sure
from all over.
Sure built themselves a nice little life here, didn't they?
I'll take a look, sure.
Everything is sold as is.
Make a move, and I'll end you, Wastelander.
Ammo, weapons, and messy death. I got it all.
Hey, Cricket.
Come on, come on! Get your guns here. Small booms, big booms. I got them all.
Let's see what you got.
And there they are! Did your heart skip a beat, too?
I might be a doctor one day. Or maybe a sharpshooter.
Not acceptable. Imogene is missing, and I want her found.
She's not missing, Mother.
Do you know where she is?
So did you find out what happened to the courier?
She is missing, and I want her found. What else is Edward for, if not to keep the family safe?
Some Mother, raiders set up camp near Parsons and ambushed him. I took care of it.
I don't like raiders operating so close to Parsons. I hope this isn't the start of something serious. What about the serum he was carrying? Did you get any of it back?
You speak so disrespectfully. Your sister. I can't bear to think what might be happening to Imogene right now.
Mother, will you let it go, please?
There was only this one vial left.
Oh, good. I was afraid we wouldn't get any of it back. Here's your pay for the job. I'm throwing in a little bonus for bringing back the serum. That was good work. Now, as far as what's next... Oh, hell. I guess it's time you met Wilhelmina. Jack's not gonna be happy about it. Come on.
And you don't even
can't actually live here, right?
I can't believe you don't care what happens to yourself.
Jack. Mrs. Cabot, don't worry. I'll send someone to find Imogene.
Thank you, Edward. I can always count on you. Why can't you be as devoted as dear Edward?
You shouldn't indulge her, Edward. It just makes her more impossible to deal with next time.
Just doing my job. Speaking of which, here's all we got back of the last delivery from Parsons. Raiders got the rest of it, I'm sorry to say.
Good. Like this. Finally, this will help settle experience. Mother down.
Imogene is Jack's sister. You probably figured that out yourself. She's, a little flighty. Impulsive. From time to time, she runs off. Usually with a new boyfriend. Then I send somebody to bring her home.
Do you know where she's gone?
No, but it shouldn't be too hard to find out. She's been spending a lot of time in Good Neighbor. At the jazz club there, the third rail. Somebody there must know something. She's not known for keeping her mouth shut.
What if she doesn't want to come home?
Obviously, as one of the family, you can't just knock her in the head and drag her home by her heels. Usually, by the time I send someone after her, she's gotten bored with the whole thing and is ready to come home. I'm sure you'll think of something. You're supposed to be resourceful, remember?
Hey there.
Yes?
Quite a place you've got here. Amazing that it survived the war.
Thank you. I try not to take it for granted. We were definitely more fortunate than most. It hasn't been easy keeping it up to pre-war standards, but we do what we can. Was there anything else?
What's going on at that old insane asylum?
I carry out some of my research there. That's all you need to know.
The more I know, the better I'll be at my job.
Well, I suppose that may be true. My father is confined in Parsons. For his own safety and everyone else's, he became dangerously unstable after handling an ancient artifact he found in Arabia. I've spent my life trying to figure out how to cure him. Are we done?
I was intrigued by your theory about an ancient alien civilization.
Actually, it was my father's theory. Now proven beyond doubt, although only to me, unfortunately. There aren't many archaeology journals publishing these days.
You said your father found a lost city?
Yes. He spent years looking, and was widely ridiculed by the so-called experts. I'm ashamed to say even I doubted him. But in the end, he found it. A lost city, buried in the sands of the Rub al-Khali, the empty quarter of Arabia. Millennia older than the earliest human civilizations, but with technology that seems to have surpassed our own. And yet, everything about it is strange, disturbing geometries, tools not made for human hands, carvings that hint at dimensions beyond our own.
What was your father's theory?
He believed that all of the earliest human civilizations shared some common parent that was unknown to history. Think of Atlantis. The myth of an advanced civilization destroyed by a cataclysm is shared by many widely separated ancient cultures. Eventually, he found what he was looking for. A lost city, buried beneath the sands of the empty quarter of the Arabian desert.
You have proof.
Enough to satisfy me. Because of his illness, my father could not, or would not, explain exactly where he found the lost city. So I've had to confine my studies to what he brought back from his first expedition. But that's been enough to show beyond a doubt that the city he found wasn't made by or for human beings.
I wanted to ask you about something else.
All right.
How'd your father manage to travel to Arabia with the world blown to hell?
Ah, well, that was before the war, when he was a young man.
Come on. The war was 200 years ago.
You know your history. Most people don't grasp how long ago the war really was. One of the effects of my father's illness was a slowing or arresting of the aging process. So, yes, he is well over 200 years old, as you suspected. Any more questions?
I've got to get going.
All right.
Jack says there's no hurry about finding Imogene, but he doesn't mean it. Now you've met the matriarch of the family. Explains a lot, doesn't it?
Looks like we got another freak, just won't fit anywhere else.
Heads up.
What you got?
Hey, Hancock.
Shoot.
I need you to get out of your power armor.
Done.
You need something to take the
Heads
edge
up.
Off?
Got my attention.
Hotel Wexford.
Shoot.
He'll hook you up.
Smell that? That's freedom.
Head over there.
We should get drinks at the third rail later.
Up there.
Sure. I love hearing Magnolia sing.
Great. Just don't go all teary on me. That big heartbreaker number starts and suddenly you're a damn fountain.
Hey, I'm getting over something.
Look alive.
Okay? A little compassion over here.
You can get your compassion from the booze.
Move out.
Mayor, citizen. You got it.
You should have hollered. I would have had your back.
Don't have no hand now. Hey, I don't mean to bitch, but aren't you supposed to be headed?
Even a girl with an arsenal full of weapons needs to make a living, after all. Don't keep me waiting, baby. Something you like? See something you like? Staring is free. Everything else is wholesale. See something you like?
Looks like we got another freak, just won't fit anywhere else.
Hey.
What do you need?
Hey,
what you got?
Stay free, man.
Hey.
Got my attention.
Yeah?
Huh? Don't have no handouts.
Means a lot to me that you made the library a safer place. Thanks again. Now you're here to trade.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Remember, no returns, exchanges, or death threats.
requests.
Any friend of Mayor Hancock is a friend of the third rail.
Hi.
Downstairs. Don't bother the other patrons.
She likes to make friends with people. She might know more about this missing bird.
Magnolia! This guy wants a word!
You're blocking my light, man?
Ever been to kill or be killed? Some fine-looking weapons.
Excuse me, miss?
What's the matter, handsome? Don't tell me you didn't like the song.
I love the song. It was perfect.
Angelic as usual, Max.
Oh, well, thank you. A girl tries her best. Now, there's something special about you, isn't there? Don't tell me. Let me guess. Ah, of course. It's those powerful muscles of yours. My, I could get used to looking at those. So what brings a man like you to my part of town?
I came here for the music.
Flatterer. I think you and I are gonna get along. So it's my turn to answer questions, right? What can I do for you?
Do you know Emogene Cabot?
Emogene? Sure. I know her. I haven't seen her in a while, though. Are you a friend of hers?
She's missing, and her family's worried about her.
I'm glad somebody's looking out for her. She seemed like a body that could use looking after.
Please, tell me what you know.
There was this preacher fella who used to come in here all the time. One of the slick ones. Always going on about remaking your life and so on. Most of the customers wouldn't give him the time of day, but Emogene, she latched on to him for some reason. I don't suppose it hurt that he was easy on the eyes. Intense. Some women find that irresistible.
Pam! Would you come over here a minute?
Is there a problem, Miss Magnolia?
No. This fine gentleman here was just looking for Emogene. Do you happen to know where that preacher fella came from?
Brother Thomas?
Yes, that's right. The one Emogene was always hanging on.
Had to throw him out. Wouldn't stop bothering customers with that salvation racket. Kept going on and on about joining him at the back bay. Then he'd shove those stupid flyers in your face. Here, I kept one of them, just in case he didn't pay his bar tab.
Well, thanks, honey. You were a big help.
Anything for you, miss.
I hope Imogene's all right. I didn't much like the idea of her going off with that preacher fella.
So, seems you know how to hold your own. I'd had my doubts when we first hit the road.
Thanks. You're not so bad yourself.
I never get many complaints. It's just real rare these days. Find someone who's not willing to take things the way they're handed to them.
Too many good folks not willing to get their hands dirty. And too many assholes taking advantage of it. Look at what happened at Diamond City. Before McDonough took over, it was a half-decent place to live. A little stricter than I usually go for, but not terrible. I thought he and I had a pretty happy childhood. But then he decides he's gonna try and get elected with his anti-ghoul crusade. Mankind for McDonough. Before you know it, you got families with kids lining up to drag folks they call neighbor out of their homes and throw them to the ruins.
You and McDonough knew each other as kids?
Oh yeah. Guy's my brother. Grew up together in a little shack on the waterfront. Guy was the standard big brother. Entitled. Punchy. Liked to shove rotten potatoes down my shirt, slap my back. But I never thought he'd be capable of something like what they did to those ghouls.
Why did McDonough campaign against the ghouls?
Because he thought he could win. There'd always been a pretty clear divide between the folks living in the stands and those down on the field. I'm not convinced they didn't do it just to improve their view. I remember storming into his office above the stands after the inauguration speech. He was just standing there, staring out the window, watching as the city turned on the ghouls. He didn't even look at me. Just said, "I did it, John. It's finally mine." Should have killed him right there, but I don't think it would have changed anything. Instead, I pleaded with him, begged him to call it off. He said he couldn't. He had nothing against the ghouls. He was just carrying out the will of the people. And he couldn't betray the voters. And then he smiled. That hideous fucking mile-long smile. He never smiled like that when we were kids. I didn't even recognize him.
What do you mean you didn't recognize him?
I don't know. Just didn't seem like the guy I grew up with. When I'd first heard the rumors, he'd been swapped for a synth. Thinking back on that night, I thought it made a lot of sense. But now, I don't know. I don't think I buy it. I've seen him since then, and there's no way they copied him that perfectly. Even got his tight-ass walk. But at the time, I just needed to get the hell away from him. Him and that whole damn city.
Of all the things I've seen since leaving the vault, this seems almost merciful.
Sure. No one got beheaded. First. I still wasn't a ghoul at this point, so I didn't have to leave, but I couldn't bring myself to stay in that cesspool after that. I'd been sneaking off the good neighbor for years to get decent chems, so I knew the safe routes. I managed to track down a couple of the families, lead them there, but most couldn't get used to the good neighbor lifestyle. I brought them food for a couple of weeks, but after a while, they just disappeared. Folks in Diamond City signed their death warrants. And all the good people were willing to just sit by and watch. I felt like I was the only one who saw how screwed up things truly were. Who couldn't just pretend things were fine. Still feel that way. Or, I did. Until I met you. I know I run my mouth, but having someone who sees the world for what it is, and is willing to do something about it, it's meant a lot to me. I feel damn lucky to have you as a friend.
And that's what we are? Friends?
Well, now that you mention it, I have been having slightly more impure thoughts than usual. Maybe we'll get to, act on those. But I guess we should probably head out, huh? After you.
Hell of a load you're carrying. Better sell some to Daisy before someone swipes it.
Enjoy your stay.
Welcome, neighbor. We're always glad to see a new face around here. Tell me something. You ever feel like this whole world is broken? Do you ever wonder why things can't be the way they were in the good old days?
The whole world is broken.
That's what I used to think. Until I found a way to make a difference. To transform my life. And maybe everyone else's too. We call ourselves the Pillars of the Community. We're a pretty new movement, so you may not have heard of us. But we're growing fast all across the Commonwealth, and you can be part of this exciting future. Step right this way, and I'll be happy to tell you all about our movement and how you can be a part of it.
Sounds good.
Well, that's just fantastic. I know you're going to fit right in around here. Don't worry. I don't bite.
I think I caught that once.
Right this way, neighbor. Don't be shy. Just follow me. Alrighty. I hope you're as excited as I am. This is one of my favorite parts of the job, getting to welcome new members into our movement. The first step is simple. You have to learn to give up your attachment to material possessions in order to gain the ability to have true wealth, health, and happiness. Just go ahead and give me everything you own, and I'll initiate you as a first-level pillar of the community.
Hey now, we earned these material possessions. You ain't seriously just gonna give them away.
Looking for new members.
I'm actually just looking for Emogene Cabbot.
Thank you.
be Imogene.
Don't tell me. Jack sent you.
Damn, ain't this place orderly. Guess I should have wiped my feet before I came in, huh?
That's right. I'm here to rescue you.
What makes you think I need to be rescued?
You're Jack's sister. I was expecting someone a bit younger.
You really know how to flatter a lady, don't you? Just to be clear, I'm Jack's younger sister, the baby of the family. Once I get home and get some of Jack's serum, I'll be back to my usual stunning self.
Jack has a serum that reverses aging?
It's more like it halts aging. I started taking it when I was 32, so normally that's what I look like. You'll see once I get my treatment. I was well known as one of the belles of Boston society, back when there was any.
What happens if you don't get more serum?
Oh, I don't think we need to worry about that. I've gone without a treatment much longer before with no lasting effect.
Yeah, whatever. Let's get going already.
It wasn't my idea for you to come down here poking your nose into my business.
Do you want to get out of here or not?
Well, yes. I've been waiting to see if Thomas would come to his senses. But since you've already gone to all this trouble, I may as well leave now. I was bored with Thomas anyway. He seemed so interesting at first. But after we got here, he turned out to be just another brute. He actually thought it could force me to join his absurd cult.
Need anything before we go?
No. I didn't bring anything worth taking with me. Oh, I'm not going with you. You can tell Mother I'll be along home before too long. I just need a drink first. You can tell Mother I'll be home soon.
think it's clearing up.
People can actually
switch to single sideband modulating. Can you hear me?
Hey.
Not now. Edward, switch over to the heartbeat modulator. Do you copy?
Gino, how's this?
Oh, that's stunning. Edward, what's going on there?
We're under attack. They're inside the building.
Inside? Can you keep them out of the basement?
I'm trying, Jack. I've never seen raiders this... For God's sake, Sammy, the doorway, right there. Sorry, things are a little busy around here right now.
Listen, if they're inside the building, you have to go to the office and shut down the elevator. You can't risk them getting to Lorenzo.
Got it. Office. Elevator. You better round up whoever you can and get them.
Hello? Edward? Come in! Edward!
Ah!
There's no signal at all. I've lost him.
What's happening, Jack? If these people are inside Parsons, if they free him...
Don't worry, I'll handle it.
I always knew it would end this way. I never should have allowed you to lock up Lorenzo in that place.
That isn't helping, Mother. And as I recall, using the serum was your idea, not mine.
So what are you going to do?
I said I'll handle it. I'm thinking.
Who are you again?
What's going on?
That was Edward. He's at Parsons, the old asylum. They're under attack by raiders. It's strange. The guards have held off raiders before without any trouble. I don't know what's gone wrong this time.
I found Emogene. She's fine.
Oh, yes. Good.
Thank God. At least one small comfort on this terrible day.
You'll be wanting to be paid, of course. Edward usually handles these things. Caps is what you use for currency, isn't that right? Here. I hope that's the right amount. Now, we really need to focus on the current emergency.
How can you be so callous about your sister's safety?
I wonder if these could be the same raiders that stole that last shipment. If some of them had used the undiluted serum, it could explain their unusual success against Edward's men.
What exactly does this serum do?
I suppose it's time you knew. The main benefit of the serum is to halt aging. My family and I are all over 400 years old, but it also confers other side effects, especially in the undiluted form that the raiders stole. It increases strength and resistance to all kinds of physical damage, so at least some of these raiders may be much more dangerous than the ones you're used to dealing with.
If you're 400 years old, then you were born before the Great War.
Yes. I think you were, too. I'd say... mid-21st century?
What makes you think that?
Patterns of speech, general demeanor, physical health. You reminded me of the old days the moment I laid eyes on you. I just didn't put my finger on it until now. Is there anything else before we get going?
Where do you get this serum from?
As you probably guessed, my father is the source of the serum.
Jack, are you sure it's wise telling him all this?
In the course of my attempts to cure him, I discovered that the artifact had introduced anomalies into his blood. So the source of his insanity is also the basis of the treatments that have prolonged all our lives. The irony isn't lost on me, but if he were to escape from Parsons, I would lose my father forever. I will not allow that to happen. Not to mention that the artifact has made him paranoid, homicidally violent, and endowed with extraordinary abilities.
Exactly what abilities does he have?
Enhanced strength, unusual resistance to most kinds of physical damage. Oh, and a kind of local telekinesis, which appears to be projected by the artifact itself. That's why I've built a dampening field into his cell. Which is why we really need to stop these intruders before they turn it off. Before we go, I need you to understand something. When we get to Parsons, you need to do exactly what I tell you. Nothing more, nothing less. Is that clear?
Got it.
Good. Make sure you have whatever you'll need for a serious battle. I'll wait for you outside.
Jack, be careful. And try not to hurt him.
I love Father at least as much as you do. But you know as well as I do that if he gets free, there will only be one option.
Don't let it come to that, please.
I'll do my best, Mother. And if Imogene finally comes home, for God's sake, don't let her leave again until I get back. Now, I really do have to go.
Excuse me.
I don't need anything right now, thank you.
That's too much. Give something here.
Won't be able to pick this. Loctite.
More shooters of jet in this place and feel just like home. Just say the word if you want to take a little chem break. Someone's got way too much time on their hands if they can get a place this clean.
Wandering into places like this is how people end up lab experiments. Trust me.
Security's too good.
Damn, nothing but junk. You damn shit. Just tell me what's on your mind.
Looking for more work if you got any.
Nothing right now, sorry. But check around the neighborhood. Always something going on.
Heads up.
Just say the word.
Ready? Let's go. Just to be clear, under no circumstances can we allow Lorenzo to be freed from Parsons. I would have lost my father forever. I refuse to let that happen after spending so long trying to cure him.
Thank you.
artifact that's made Lorenzo so dangerous. I'm sure his psychosis would be cured if it could be removed. But so far, all my attempts have failed. It's fused too tightly with his nervous system. I'm well aware of the apparent conflict of interest in my father being the source of the treatment that is prolonging my own life. But I assure you, if I had the chance, I would gladly give it all up to have my father back, even for a short time.
The only way you get old in this job is assume everyone's out
to kill
you.
The best way to spend your caps is protecting your hide with my armor. That advice is free.
Sure. Let's take a look.
Focus on stopping power. Pretty, don't stop bullets.
Be time to part with some of those gains?
Got a minute?
Come on. We need to find out what's happening at Parsons.
Too many miles on the road. At least the pay is terrible.
Business is good.
Bad move!
machines that just breed and eat. Come to think of it, that don't sound half bad.
Tell the good doc what's wrong with you. Spend your caps, and I'll make it all better.
Could use some supplies, actually.
I got loads of stim packs, chems, you name it.
Thank you.
You have some sort of medical problem here, or are you just yanking my chain?
Take whatever you can. I'll keep watch.
Hey, I got something.
it's hurting, we hurt him. It's not hard.
Hey, pal.
Get it while I got it.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Ah, now you're talking.
Faster ways to cripple yourself than trying to lug all that.
Do not interfere with security operations.
Suckers!
Neutralized. Recommend immediate repairs to private.
plenty of folks want to make life hard for people just trying to survive. I'm not willing to stand for that kind of shit.
I need you to get out of your power armor.
Done.
Hey.
Got my attention.
Enough to go around.
Heads up.
Shoot.
Wait there.
Gotcha. I'll keep an eye out.
Heads up.
Guess I'll just make myself at home.
Never built much myself. I'm not supposed to operate heavy machinery.
Diamond City, huh? Well, they ain't real fond of ghouls in this town.
Or get back to writing the paper. I guess the paper can wait.
Sure, let's go.
Will do.
Taking up with Little Miss Reporter, huh? I'm jealous.
I can't tell if that's a compliment or a pickup line or both, so I think we're just gonna go. Point the way.
Piper.
You holding up, Blue?
Why are you calling me that?
Because you're a vault dweller? I know you're not wearing the blue jumpsuit right now, but the Pip-Boy and the fish out of water look... dead giveaways. So here's the deal. I want an interview. Your life story in print. I think it's time Diamond City had a little outside perspective on the Commonwealth. Besides, I'm already following you around. Might as well get some quotes while we're at it.
What kind of interview is this gonna be?
I ask you who you are, get your opinion on life out there, and maybe load up a few tough questions and keep it interesting. What do you say?
All right, Piper. I'm in.
Good. Let's get down to business. So, I know you're from a vault. How would you describe your time on the inside?
My family and I were frozen. I didn't spend much time in the vault.
Wait, they boxed you up in a fridge? The whole time? Are you saying you were alive before the war?
Yes. I'm over 200 years old.
Oh my god. The man out of time. So, you've seen the Commonwealth, Diamond City. How does it compare to your old life?
Honestly, seeing everyone surviving out here, rebuilding the world, it gives me hope.
That's surprisingly inspired, Blue. We're definitely quoting that. For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want you to make a statement to Diamond City directly. The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. Everyone wants to pretend it just doesn't happen. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one but might be too scared or too numb to the world to look for them?
You can only take it one day at a time. Just keep going. That's all anyone can do.
We're all just doing what we have to, huh? I think my readers can relate to that. That's everything. It's gonna take some time to put this all together, but I think your story is gonna give Diamond City plenty to talk about. Anyway, we should probably get going. Thanks again.
alive.
Just let me know. Big, loud, full of corrupt officials and brown-nosing citizens, but it's home.
We sell everything. Skin packs, ammunition, outerwear, dinnerware.
I'll take a look, sure.
The highest quality available.
Good neighbor, huh? You looking to get stoned or stabbed?
So, ready to get this show on the road?
Not now.
Suit yourself.
Hey.
Where to? Hey, here. Something to keep sharp. Always work for me.
I need you to get out of your power armor.
You got it.
Thank you.
Hey, Valentine.
Time to hit the road?
Let's head out.
Well, all right.
Heads up.
What's the plan? Looking for something?